And why, as well, we will learn that every prophet and messenger that carried the message of Islam went through hardship. Carrying the message of Islam is not easy. And we mentioned last week, Naik Badr Rashid mentioned, not last week, the week before, the reason why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down to Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, which we believe is a second revelation. Second revelation after the first revelation. The first revelation was اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق خلق الإنسان من علق اقرأ وربك الأكرم الذي علم بالقلم علم الإنسان ما لم يعلم. Went through in maybe in sixth lesson, الله أعلم, seventh lesson, when Quran revealed. The first time Quran was revealed. And when we say Quran revealed, we don't mean the completion of the Quran, at the beginning of the Quran, when the Quran began to be revealed to Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we know that the Quran was revealed within the duration of the prophethood of 23 years. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was a prophet and a messenger for 23 years. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And after this, the wahi stopped. The Sayyidina Jibreel came for the first time. اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق. And then he didn't come after that for 40 days. Allahu Akbar. And how difficult it was for Sayyidina Muhammad's mental state. And of course, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala kept him at ease. Because don't forget Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his capability mentally, psychologically, physically, emotionally, was at the strength and amplified beyond 40 prophets. And imagine gathering 40 anbiya, 40 prophets into one man. That was Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And each prophet had the strength of 10 mighty men. 10 mighty men. So 10 times 40 is 400, man. Am I right or am I gone wrong in my maths? So 400. Approximately, and just to give us an insight of how strong Sayyidina Muhammad is, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But as well, he was a human. But the best and the strongest of all humans. And the preferred one. To be the best of the best, Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For 40 days, Allahu Akbar, 40 days. Imagine, no wahi. Sayyidina Jibreel came down as the form of a man. And then he showed him his true form in the horizon. He said, he's seen Sayyidina Jibreel as the man. And he's seen Sayyidina Jibreel in his true essence with 600 wings. The beauty of Sayyidina Jibreel is, mashallah, yani uncomprehendable. Sayyidina Muhammad gives us an insight, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that his wings were so beautiful, so elegant, that he had multicolor feathers. And the colors all coincided with one another. It was a perfect balance of colors. To the point that it was surur للناظرين إذا نظروا. يعني it was a soothing sight and gazing upon the wings of Sayyidina Jibreel if they were able to see. But Allah allowed Sayyidina Rasul to see, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And it was said that he had like a silky shiny like feathers on his feet. Like green feathers on his feet, Allahu Akbar. 600 wings, 300 on the right and 300 on the left. The way they were, Allah created them to be intertwining into one another, overlapping one another. A perfect creation of Allah Azza wa Jal. A mighty creation of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Sayyidina Jibreel, archangel, صاحب الوحي. And he was the one that allocated by Allah to reveal to the Prophet and messengers. And after all that, 40 days. In that generation of 40 days, we said that after Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he gathered his close kith and kin from his family, and his uncles, and his aunts. And he gave him the message of La ilaha illallah, Muhammad al-Rasulullah. And the five verses or six verses, اقرأ بسم ربك الذي اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق خلق الإنسان من علق اقرأ وربك الأكرم الذي علم بالقلم علم الإنسان ما لم يعلم. Five verses. And then after that, a few days later, a week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, Allahu Akbar, there's no new revelation from the Prophet to the people. Allahu Akbar. So now the people took this opportunity to try to hurt Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because he came with Tawheed. He came with the proper creed, the doctrine, which every human should acknowledge and submit to, which is La ilaha illallah. And when we say La ilaha illallah, you're automatically يعني لا صنم ولا هبل ولا لات ولا العزة ولا منات إله غير الله. يعني لا إله إلا الله, there is no gods. يعني your لات, your هبل, your منات, they're not gods. You gotta يعني negate the fact that they're gods or they adore to God, and you believe in the one true God, Allah Azza wa Jal. So now they're saying, look, he came to abolish our livelihood. We make money from these gods. So that they did not like the message, even though they understood and know that Sayyidina Muhammad is a sadiq الوعد الأمين ولا يكذب صلى الله عليه وسلم. He's the trustworthy one, the honest one, the one that was never tried for his honesty, nor did they witness any lies, small or big lies, not even his joking of Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم comprised of any lies. So they knew the honesty of Sayyidina Rasulullah, but they hated the fact that he came with a message that will abolish the idol worship, their money-making machine. But now they started to begin what? To irritate, try to distract the people from the call of Sayyidina Rasulullah by bringing in something that might discourage them. Okay? So one lady, it was said, maybe it was the wife, we said the wife of Abi Lahab. تَبَّتْ يَدَى أَبِي لَهَبٍ وَتَبْ. Right? It was either the wife of Abu Lahab, the wife of the uncle of the Prophet ﷺ, or her friend. We don't know. Or I don't know. But there was two opinions. So she said, Ya Muhammad, I see that the devil has left you. Look, see how she's accusing him of already bringing something that's not from God. But now the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is becoming concerned. So Allah sent what before? Ya ayyuha al-muzammil, qum al-layla illa qalila. And before, Ya ayyuha al-muddathir, qum fa-anzir. Before that, before the mission, Allah wanted to console His Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So Allah sent down وَالضُّحَى وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا سَجَى مَا وَدَّعَكَ رَبُّكَ وَمَا قَلَى وَلَلْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنَ الْأُولَى وَلَسَوْفَ يُعْطِيكَ رَبُّكَ فَتَرْضَى. Who said these verses? Not the complete duha, but from Surah Duha, that's what came. consoling Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him the command. Ya ayyuhal mudda, O rapt one, rise and pronounce and proclaim Islam. Qum fa'andir, and warn people. Another is from the indhar. Qum fa'andir, now warn the people, be careful. Qum fa'andir, if you denounce or if you disbelieve in the messagehood of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you're going to be held to account. But then after that, he went out and started to proclaim the message. We don't want to take too much of your time. But something happened in that duration of time as well, which I'd like to focus upon and not get any further if possible. Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, radiallahu anhu arda. That's why, by learning the seerah, you'll understand that there's no ifs and buts about it, that Allah Azza wa Jal willed for Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq to be the natural successor, the first Khalifa. If you learn, if you go through the seerah of Sayyidina Rasul, and you will know the wisdom of Allah, why Allah chose Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. The first thing that Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq did in the seerah is that he sacrificed his life. He risked his life for Sayyidina Rasulullah. And after the passing away of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was the one that stood his ground emotionally, kept sound, and he went up how hard, he went up even though it was so difficult. And he said, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ مَنْ كَانَ يَعْبُدُ مُحَمَّدٍ فَمُحَمَّدٍ قَدْ مَاتٍ وَمَنْ كَانَ يَعْبُدُ وَمَنْ يَعْبُدُ اللَّهِ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ حَيٌّ لَا يَمُوتٍ إِنَّكَ مَيِّتٌ وَإِنَّهُمْ مَيِّتُونَ. In certain verses, he said, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq got up. The old people, the best friend, the first one to convert to Islam, the father-in-law of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, comforter from amongst his friends, Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. He got up. How hard is it when our loved ones, our fathers, our mothers, our children, when they pass away, don't speak to me at least for a day or two. You know, I'm not able to speak soundly. I might even mix up my words because of my emotions. Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu arda, at that moment, the hardest moment, waqt al-sadam. Yani, what do they call sadam, Shaykh Ahmed? Sadam, yani. Ghafli, yani. A surprising news. The death of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he got up. And then he was the one that waged war against Musaylim al-Kizzab and his followers. Bani Hanifa, the tribe of Bani Hanifa, one of the biggest tribes in the Najd region, in the Arab Peninsula. Najd is big, big. It's like New South Wales. Sweet New South Wales, the towns and villages and cities and so forth. But the first thing they wanted to denounce is zakat. They want to break one pillar of Islam. They said, Ya Abu Bakr, aw Khalifa Rasulillah, aw the successor of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we don't have to pay zakat anymore. The Prophet died, we used to give it to him, we give it to no one else. That's it, we don't have to. We'll keep on praying, not a problem. Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, there's no give and take when it comes to Islam. There's no give and take when it comes to Islam. But he warned them and they did not take heed of his warning. But he gathered the Sahaba al-Kiram were going towards people. Sayyidina Umar and the likes, even Sayyidina Ali, even Sayyidina Abu Ubaidah. And all of them, they came to Sayyidina Rasul, Ya, O Messenger of Allah, please. O successor of the Prophet, Abu Bakr. They're Muslims. Even maybe if we give them time, we'll speak to them over the days and years, maybe they'll come back to you. He said, no. أَيَنْقُصُ الدِّينُ وَأَنَا حَيٌّ. You think the religion will decrease or a pillar will be smashed as long as I'm alive? Whilst I'm alive? See how he stood? See how he is the natural successor? It's logical that if it was someone else, they would have had a softer heart. And we say, Sayyidina Abu Bakr has got a soft heart. He has. When he comes to deen, he's a lion heart. Asad Allah wa Rasulu. It's a lion, Sayyidina Abu Bakr. We'll mention, inshaAllah ta'ala, won't take too much of a time, inshaAllah ta'ala. Okay. The companions who embraced Islam by the invitation of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. We're going to mention them, and then we'll give room for questions and answers, inshaAllah. Many companions embraced Islam in response to the invitation of Abu Bakr. May Allah be pleased with him. Of them, a mention may be made of Uthman ibn Affan. Okay? They give you like Uthman ibn Affan, ibn Abu al-As, ibn Umayyah, ibn Abdi Shams, ibn Abdi Manaf, ibn Qusay, ibn Kilab, ibn Murra, ibn Ka'ab, ibn Lu'ay. That's the perfect, that's the perfection of Islam and what Islam has preserved. We even know the genealogy, not only of the Prophet, but of the companions of Sayyidina Muhammad. And the Christians in the Bible that know where Mark starts and begins, Luke, Matthew, they don't know who they are. They're anonymous. So they assume they might be from the disciples. But then they realize, the biblical scholars, the Bible scholars and historians say that all the Gospels, according to, are not disciples. And they were not eyewitnesses. Just hearsay. And if you tell them, give us at least one grandfather of them, they won't know how to give it. Look, we are mentioning Uthman, we mentioned how much, 6-7 generations. So how preserved Islam is? Allahu Akbar. And that's why Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq was allocated by Allah Azza wa Jal and gave him a special talent. And that is a talent of genealogy of the Arabs. He had علم الأنساب. نسب. Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq will know. Give me the name of him, of his father. We'll give you 6-7 generations. Sometimes 20 generations, depends. So, then Uthman ibn Affan and Az-Zubayr ibn al-Awwam, ibn Khuwaylid, ibn Asad, ibn Abd al-Uzza, ibn Qusay, ibn Kilab, ibn Murra, ibn Ka'ab, ibn Lu'ay, and Abd al-Rahman ibn Awf, ibn Abdi Awf, ibn Ab, ibn al-Harith, ibn Zuhra, ibn Kilab, ibn Murra, ibn Ka'ab, ibn Nu'ay, ibn Nu'ay. Okay. And then Sa'ad ibn Abi Waqqas. And the name of Abu Waqqas is Malik ibn Uhayb, ibn Abdi Manaf, ibn Zuhra, ibn Kilab, ibn Murra, ibn Ka'ab, ibn Nu'ay, ibn Talha, Asafan ibn Nu'ay. And Talha ibn Ubaidullah, ibn Uthman, ibn Amr, ibn Ka'ab, ibn Sa'ad, ibn Taym, ibn Murra, ibn Ka'ab, ibn Lu'ay. He brought them to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they performed prayer with him. And they acknowledged Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Okay? We've mentioned how much here, I think. We mentioned, how should we count? Sayyidina Uthman, ibn Uthman, Az-Zubayr ibn al-Awwam, Sayyidina Abd al-Rahman ibn Awf, Sayyidina Sa'ad ibn Abi Waqqas, Yeah, imagine. Yes, we're mentioned four from the 10 guaranteed paradise in the lifetime of the Prophet ﷺ. So 10 men were guaranteed paradise before they met the angel of death. Okay? So there's Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, right? There's a hadith for this as well. Abu Bakr fil Jannah, wa Umar fil Jannah, wa Uthman fil Jannah, wa Ali fil Jannah, wa Zubair fil Jannah, wa Talha fil Jannah, wa Abdul Rahman ibn Auf fil Jannah, wa Sa'ad fil Jannah, wa Sa'id fil Jannah, wa Abu Ubaidah fil Jannah. And these six converted on the hands of Abu Bakr Siddiq. Isn't he a natural successor to the first Khalifa? That even the 10 Bashara were on his hands to come to Islam. Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. So Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq was the cause for the conversion of the 10 guaranteed paradise, except Sayyidina Umar, Sayyidina Ali, basically two. Right? Sayyidina Umar and Sayyidina Ali. Okay? Sayyidina Ali converted on the hands of Sayyidina Rasulullah. And Sayyidina Umar converted on the hands of his sister, Fatima bint al-Khattab. On the hands of Sa'ad ibn Zayd, who was his brother-in-law. Okay, so anyway. Do you want me to read the other 40 Sahaba that are converted, or we'll go on? Okay, so anyway, we mentioned basically. Okay, any questions? Inshallah ta'ala. Okay, any more questions? So, Allahu Akbar. In the 13 years, I count maybe 70 conversions of the Arabs. 70, Ariba. Okay? Within the first 10 years, 70 more or less. And from the 70, 40 or 35, the cause of the conversion was Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. We are on the topic of Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq as well. Let us mention an event, and inshallah ta'ala, we'll stop here. Bismillah. Okay. This event, they said, this is the first time that Sayyidina Rasulullah SAW received physical harm. Physical harm.